meets girl, here's what they say.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore.
I came in 1948 with my brother and my father. And I landed in, we came by boat 11 days, and we came to New York. And then we got a train, and we came here to Springfield. It was December 10th. Cold, snowing. Here we are, with from Italy, with the short pants.
Okay, you know? This is my grandmother, and me when I was a child. He used to say, hey, you better be a good boy because you're going to go to Italy. And there's my brother over there with a soccer ball and my sister's behind her.
So my brother started Antonio's because he used to work for Ray's Grinder, okay? And he learned the business, actually worked for a few years. And then he opened up the first Antonio was actually on Main Street himself, my brother. And then he went to Bay Street, 1963. And then from there, I at nights I used to help him out, you know, because and after a while I went in business with my brother because he was opening up another one as Epperman Triangle. It used to be Waldorf, and the second Antonio became the second Antonio.
Working with my husband, it's good. It's a good thing. It keeps us in tune with one another. We have our good days and we have our bad days. And we do disagree some, but most of the time we're on the same page. It's good. I can keep an eye on them, that's for sure. I make sure everybody's doing the right thing, and we have a lot of young people working. So sometimes it's almost like babysitting.
From here is my daughter Gina. She buys it and all the products, all the food for Antonio. My other two daughters, they work for a cosmetic company in Jaffa, where they sell all the product, the female product for anything.
My father is the most compassionate, caring, loving man in the world. He just has a heart, has such a big, big, big heart. Not only for his family, but also for all his employees.
Yeah, he just wants to help people, watch them succeed. When the employees work here, he knows it's a stepping stone for a lot of things, and he knows that. And then in a few years, they go on and move on, and then they'll come back and visit him and say, oh, Sammy, you know, I remember when I used to work here. Now I'm doing this and that, and it just makes him feel so good that he was, you know, part of their lives.
Yeah, he has impacted a lot of people's lives. He doesn't even realize how many people's lives he's impacted.
We had Bay Street, we had Chester Street, Antonio's, and Southwick. Then we sold the one on Southwick, and my brother opened up one on State Street.
I got my start here at Antonio's when I was very young. My uncle and my dad bought the place. My uncle actually started it, and they started working, and then I started coming with them to work, and they impressed me very much the way they used to work, and it's the only job I've ever had ever since. This Antonio's is different because it's in a different part of the city. I cater to a lot of schools, colleges, high schools. There's a lot of walking traffic here. I have a drive-through. It's pretty much me and my wife run this location. My kids used to work here. They all have worked here, but they went out to college and now they have other jobs doing something different. They didn't want to pursue a restaurant career like I did, which is fun. I have my sister-in-law here as far as family and a bunch of other trusted employees that I've had here for many, many years. We started off with Grinders when we first opened. We didn't have pizza till maybe 10 years after we originally started. So. We added pizza, then we added wraps, and we pretty much have to change to the way our customers' eating changes. Like, different generations have different tastes. So if you looked at our menu from 10 years ago, you wouldn't see probably half the stuff that's on it now.
Okay, here you see the menu.
consists of grinders. The grinders are, you can see it's all different kinds. There are cold grinders, hot grinders, and whatever grinder you want, so you see the prices, they're visible, it'll be priced in. Then you, if you move on your left, you see the pizza. Pizza, you have 5 different kinds of pizzas, sizes, and whatever you want. You want to create your own pizzas. We have a white pizza, buffalo, barbecue, pepperoni, whatever you want. Well explored. So after you're working all your life, I says I have to put a bank. So they call a bank of the Calabria, which was that, that's how I was born. So I create a bank where you go every day and do the transaction. You deposit money, get change for the operation for the Antonio's.
It was always a part of our life, so I don't know what it would be like without being part of a family business.
Right, we didn't know anything else.
We didn't know anything else because we were so young when my father started the business. I think I was in like second grade.
Yeah, I think so.
So, and of course, I'm only 35 now, so it's just, you know what it is? It's a part of who we are as a family. It's a part of our discussion every Sunday at dinner. It's something that we all have in common. We all have our own families. We even have, you know, some of our children live in different parts of the United States. But Antonio's is the thing that brings us all together.
Right, it's the root. It's our roots. Family. It's in our hearts and our soul from day one almost. So that's, we don't know anything else.
Right.
It's the only job I've ever had. So I wasn't kind of like forced into it, but it's become such a part of my life for a long time that it's almost natural for me. To me, it's not really work. You know, it's just part of my everyday life. So, you know.
He doesn't realize the legacy that he's built for not only his family, but for a lot of families that from Springfield, that's pretty cool. I think after, I want to put a statue somewhere, you know, like how they have, like.
Oh, yes. Oh, like, yeah. We have his picture over there when it was 18.
But, like, somewhere in the city so that when people, because, you know, I don't know if this building will be here forever, but so that Antonio's lives on forever, even though the building may not be here, but the impact and the memories will be here forever. So I think it would just be a really cool thing.
Yeah.
In honor of him, you know? So it's just so cool. Because we love him, you know?
Mm-hmm. So wouldn't trade him for the world.
No. Nope. And we love Springfield. That's why we're here.
So. I'd like to thank my father for showing me, you know, what it is to work and be a family man. He's my idol. I'm everything because of him. And my parents, they showed me everything and they welcomed me into the business. And he actually takes my ideas now. So I'm very happy about that. So that's how I like to thank everybody, pretty much. Thanks.
My kids, they're more efficiently. They almost have taken over. To me, this became a hobby. I got up in the morning, I set up the place, and then I go 2-3 times a week at the YMCA and to try to stay healthy. And for me right now, I go back to Florida, back and forth, and I want to age gracefully, and eventually just to stay out and let my family take over.
The future for Antonio's will be in the hands of my children. And they do a good job. They're doing a very good job now running it, and it helps us out an awful lot. And I hope Tony's will be here for years and years after we're not. But only time will tell.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore.
Antonio's
when the world you shine like you've had
pastrami
sun
and a slice of pepperoni pizza.
Let's wrap it up.
And I always told them, you guys just don't know what love is. They say, what is love? I say, Antonio's love and pizza.
Happy Thanksgiving. Thank you.
When the stars make